Hey everyone, what's up? I'm Clay Nelson, and I'm going to be talking to you guys today about the process of applying to college as an engineering major. So for some context, I'm a junior at Cornell University, and I'm in the College of Engineering. I major in Operations Research and Engineering, and I minor in Business and Data Science. So I applied through this college application process to only engineering majors across 10 different universities, and really got to see a lot of similarities in what that application process looked like, and looking back on it, have some tips as to what is really expected and what some colleges are really looking for with their applicants when it comes to being an engineering major. So the first thing that I want to talk about is standardized tests. So regardless of some universities, it's recommended. Some universities is required for the SAT and the ACT, but I would say with most engineering programs, the SAT is required. I think every university that I applied to had the SAT or ACT required. And beyond that, there were also subject tests. So if you're not familiar with subject tests, they're shorter exams that are offered by the College Board, and they test in a variety of different subject areas, whether that be chemistry or physics or math or biology, and then also in the liberal arts, like history. I believe there's also one in Spanish and different languages. So there are a lot of different subjects that are tested for in the subject tests, and you can take whatever ones you like. When you apply as an engineering major, there's often either the recommendation or the requirement that you submit subject tests in STEM fields. So when I applied to Cornell, I applied into the College of Engineering. And as part of that application process, I was expected to have a subject test submitted in math and a subject test submitted in science. So I had submitted the math level 2, which is pretty common because it tests a little bit more than the math level 1, which is more SAT level math. And then I'd also taken the physics subject test, which covers things like mechanics as well as electricity and magnetism. So when I submitted those two tests as part of my application, it allowed Cornell to see that I had strengths on a higher level of math as well as in physics, which is not tested on those standardized tests. I would definitely highly recommend, even if it's not required, to take those STEM subject tests and submit those with your application, because I think that will really show these universities your skills in those fields. And beyond the SAT and the ACT, there's definitely the expectation of extracurriculars for engineers. And these are often looked for in the STEM fields, but they also want to see extracurriculars in, like, let's say, volunteer work and athletics and whatnot to really show that you're a well-rounded applicant. But with regards to the STEM extracurriculars, I can give a couple examples. So when I was a senior in high school, I took AP Physics 2 independent study. My high school did not offer it, but the teacher that taught AP Physics 1 was willing to work with me and a couple other students on going about this course independent study. And I did the textbook on my own, created labs on my own on weekends, and was able to talk about my experience of really creating this course and going about learning this material on my own when it wasn't necessarily implemented in my standard education system. And that really was able to show universities I was going the extra mile to really want to learn more about this subject area. Another thing that I did the summer before my senior year was I went to a week-long engineering camp at Purdue University and was able to learn more about what it's like being a college student in engineering and play with a bunch of different fields within engineering, whether that be biomedical or chemical or mechanical and et cetera. And that was able to show universities that I had really expressed interest in engineering before applying and that I'd really wanted to explore those different fields early on. So that's another thing that you can look into. And if you're able to do that, that would definitely be something that would be a great thing to add to your college application resume. So when I go into what makes this process different, there are some things when you're applying as an engineer that you're definitely looked at in a different way than when you're applying as maybe a non-engineering applicant. So engineers are problem solvers. They're creating new things, building new things to help make the world a better place, to advance the science and technology that we live in today. So these universities are looking for their next problem solvers of the world. So really being able to show that you're a strong problem solver, being able to show that you've been able to overcome obstacles and create solutions when the solution isn't necessarily obvious, that is a type of skill that is just so crucial to engineering. And it's really something that you might want to showcase if you have experience of being in those situations and navigating them successfully. Of course, they're also looking for a strong STEM background. You can show this in a variety of ways and some of the ways I talked about previously, but really be able to show these universities that you may have a high SAT score in the math section, but you have so much more that you actually have done in your high school time that has really shown that extra mile of interest when it comes to the STEM fields. And then beyond these types of people that the university is looking for, they also want to see on your high school transcripts that you were taking those more advanced classes that are not required just to graduate high school, but you're really taking them to learn more about the field that you want to go into. So, for example, I know my high school, I took every AP math and science class that was offered. And whether that had been AP Physics 1 or whether that had been Honors Chemistry and AP Calculus. And obviously, every high school is different. So if your high school isn't offering those types of advanced placement or IB level math and science classes, universities aren't going to hold you to it if you weren't able to take them. But if they're offered at your high school, you definitely want to take those if you're trying to go into being an engineering major at a university. And these, with the SAT subject test, can really demonstrate your academic skills in STEM, but universities are also looking for well-rounded applicants. They're looking for people that are not only able to invent something new and create something new as an engineer, but they're also looking for people that are really able to share it and communicate this research to other people. So part of being an engineer is being able to develop something and then like maybe patent it or sell it to a company. And those skills come from the liberal arts, you know, really being able to communicate with people and be business savvy. So when you're applying as an engineering major, they want to see that you've done other things that show that you're a team player. Teamwork is so pivotal in engineering. You are always working in groups, collaborating, labs, lab partners, and it's just, you need to be able to have those skills. So if you can showcase those through athletics, volunteer work, clubs, so helpful and so important that you would want to show. And then also with liberal arts, you know, if you're able to show that you're strong in English, if you're strong in like literature, for example, or maybe you're really good at history, those things really work well into engineering because like, let's say, for example, literature, being able to actually write up those research papers and show them to your professor or if you're working in a research lab. And like, let's say, for example, with history, understanding what technological and engineering feats we've accomplished in history and how current ones are building off of those previous ones. So all of these skills are just so pivotal to being in engineering. And I think that as much as there is that expectation that someone is really strong in math or science, it is really also expected that they can kind of do everything. And I think that what I want to recommend to you is just do your best, but also really showcase those skills. Showcase that you're a problem solver. Showcase your strengths in math and science, but also showcase that you're well-rounded. And I think if you go about it in that process, that would definitely really give yourself your best chance when applying as an engineering major. So I hope that this information has been helpful. I hope that you can take some things away from this and get that strong engineering application together if you want to go to university and study it.